It has been a solid, long while. What's going on, everybody? Logan Z Gamer here, and welcome finally back to Genshin Impact. Now, guys, 4.0 has dropped last night. Super hyped. This is the most hyped for Genshin I've been in a long, long while. Fontaine is finally here. Linnea and Lynette are here. Fremente, I'm pretty sure her name is. He's going to be coming out later as well. We have so much to do. So much exploring. There's underwater exploring, new automaton enemies. This is going to be a great update, guys. I've been hyped for this for so long. We're just going to get right into it. Now, I have seen the 4.1 characters that are going to be coming out. Focalors is not coming out in 4.1, so that gives me more time to grind. Probably people are wondering, why do I want to go for Focalors? Why do I not want to go, like, for, you know, like, maybe Linny or Yelan, even though I really do want Yelan. Why am I specifically going for Focalors? Well, apparently, as it's said in the trailer, Focalors, which is still going to be hard for me to say. I'm still used to saying Focalors. But, you know, because if I try to ask my name's Focalors, I'm going to have to apply to calling her Focalors now. But, Yeah, the reason why I want Focalors so bad is because the fact I only have one Archon, and I really do want another Archon. Right, handbook. I got a message.
Yo, what's up, Logan Paul?
I'm not Logan Paul. Who is this? Gamersta 120. I'm not Logan Paul, but greetings. It is nice to see, though, that I really hope that this version for Genshin is going to be fun. Because out of anything with Genshin, this is the most hyped I've been in ages. I'm pretty sure we see the world bosses. You can have a look at them here. Well, yep. I'm not going to look at any other enemies. Prelude of Blancheur and Nocturne. I don't know if I say it like that, right or not. But I don't speak French. And the elemental battle. Here. Relic records, creations of the Hydro Nation.
Magic start.
Wait. Seems it already gave us a free Lynette. That's nice. I only got the one I wanted. We got Linny. Yelan, who's returned. We got Lynette. And we got Bennett, who's also done on our show up. So, chapter 4 Linny. The Terrestrial Sea, Origin of All Waters. A story that has never been heard. A legend that has been forgotten, like a lost kingdom sunken beneath the waves, yearning for a bard to sing its drowned songs. Following the directions of pure currents, crossing wilderness, the depths of the forests, and vastness of the sea of sand, arriving at the origin of all the waters of the continent. At the top of the waterfall, in the depth of the capital atop the terrestrial sea, the curtain softly rises on the start of the adventurer's next chapter. We got one of the new bosses here. There's the other boss. And of course, Power of the Abyss reset.
Magic start.
Alright. Of course, we have our compensation primos, which is really nice. I'm not going to go through the survey. I'm not really feeling it. So we have Linny. So it seems the other rated characters are Benna, of course, and also Barbara. We have Yalon and the Weapon Banner with Aqua Simulacra and the First Great Magic Bow. I have to say, Linny's bow actually does not look too bad. I do want to look at the stats. So let's have a look. Okay, so this one's based off of crit damage. There's another bow based on crit damage, like Tainari's. Parsifal the Great. Damage dealt by charge attacks increased by 16% for every party member with the same elemental type as the wielder, including the wielder themselves. Gain one gimmick stack. For every party member with different elemental type from the wielder, gain one theoric stack. When the wielder has 1, 2, 3, or more gimmick stacks, attack will be increased by 16, 32, or 48%. When the wielder has 1 or 2 or more Thetric stacks, I still don't know how to say that. Movement speed will be increased by 4, 7, or 10%. Alright. And of course, our standard, but who cares about standard banner right now? I feel like, usually most of the time when it comes to new versions of the game, I always pull immediately whenever I have compensation premiums. And that's no exception here. We're going to do 4 pulls, try and build up our pity for Fossilores. First pull. Oh, I fucking heart attack there. I thought I was going to get a 5-star. Sacrificial fragment. At least I got myself another pole. Alright, one more. Number two. I'm gonna do it like this now. Anytime if I don't see the thing, like the meteor changing, I'm skipping. If it doesn't seem like gold or purple, like a safe blue, I'm skipping. Not gonna look at any blue weapon. The hell? Ba-ba-da! It's another pull! Bro, I'm actually kind of worried I'm going to make it all the way to my pity. I don't want to make it to pity. I have Linny, but I don't want Lynette. Wait, wrong way! I have Lynette, I don't want Linny. Why am I pulling on the Linny banner then? I don't know. I want to build up pity, and I know it's going to go wrong. And the final one. Well, almost final one. Get one more. We're starting this off a little bit with a polling fest, because one, it's been a little while, so I'm not going to get on Genshin. Okay, well, MiHoYo still doesn't like me. Fuck you too, MiHoYo. Alright, now the best part. Let's have a look at the map. Zoom out. Go down to Sumeru. Wait. There it is. Oh, wait. That's a little small. I expected Fontaine to be bigger. I mean, no doubt about it. Sumeru is literally the biggest area in the game. Like, Jesus. And I know some of my friends actually hate Sumeru, purely because of how big it is. And I can understand now why. But it seems we can access Fontaine without even needing that the Archon quests. So that is really nice. You know, I want to do Archon quests, but I want to explore. I really want to explore first. I have been hyped for this for so long. I just want to explore. Why does it still pull me in? Oh wait, it didn't pull me into a quest. The fuck happened to my team? Oh wait! Oh, that's cool. I forgot. I saw they were gonna change like the menu setup and stuff. Yeah, I mean, oh, I already have max teams, you know, so. Let me just. Just Kazuha. Okay, so let's see all the character deployment animations. So, Kazuha. That looks nice. Now, some of Genshin still seems to surprise me. I like Faruzan's. Wait, on, does Xiangling do it? Xiangling does a flip. Oh, that's cool. Somewhat of a flip. Yanfei, Chi Chi. Still not the biggest fan of Chi Chi. Still don't like her. Hazo's nice. Ningguang. Oh, I like Goro's. Mona. Tainari. Rosaria. Oh, this is with the kunai. Or the knife. That looks cool. Oh, Kuki Shinobu's also looks nice. Lisa. I saw Kali's. Kali's is cute. Xingqiu. Noelle. Chongus. Or Chongyun. Bennett. Toma. That was nice. Barbara's is cute, I have to admit. Wanderer. Ooh. Hang on, let's see that again. Oh, that one's cool. Lumia. Okay, that one's nice. Diluc. Oh, that fire. No, it's the fire in his hands. That's nice. Mayu. Kaya. Also, yes, unfortunately, I did not get Kaya's outfit. I wasn't bothered to play Genshin for a couple of versions. I was busy playing other games like Tower of Fantasy. If you guys want to see that, let me know. Could play that instead of Genshin. Xian's nice. Sarah. Yunjin. Layla's is cute. Beto. Yao Yao. Mika. Kave. We can see Lynette's now too. Oh, I like that one. Razor. Hang on, fucking power up. Dory. They're all pretty nice, have to admit. I'm definitely gonna have to try and give Lynette a shot when I get the chance to. Source Water Nation. Also, if some of you do remember from my SAO video that I recorded, you guys remember I had a lot of trouble playing the game properly because the fact of my controller being a little buggy. But now, I should be able to play games more normally now, without having trouble lagging.
Yo, the turtles!
Turtles are still here. What is that? Oh, I know, it's just a plant. Just a plant and a rock.
Dude, the boats! Look at the boats! All those look amazing!
I just started playing with Ghost.
I have to use the fish greatsword.
The Northlander weapons. I really still don't remember equipping this thing. Let me put this instead. Oh, wait. Hydroculi! The first Hydroculi. Whoa. Oh my god, wait. Look at that. That looks beautiful. Also, I never collected all two more Oculi, so I got two to gather. Never bothered to work on Sumeru. Before I even activate the statue, I want to look around these ships real quick. Because it seems I'm already finding a Hydroculi. That must mean that there could be more. There were so many ships in the air now. It's on you! Maybe some exquisite treasure chests. Would be nice. I'm betting there's something up that mast. I know there is. I'm going up there. Just going on the roof. Waterfalls, dude. Mixed in with that steampunk French aesthetic. It just doesn't look anything like French at the moment. But the music is giving off. Oh, wait, hang on. Do I just drive my Wave Rider in here?
Call the fucking poodle Baguette.
Alright. Though, so far, I'm loving the aesthetics here. Upper level of Fontaine. Wait, where's the statue then? Oh, it's still above. Nah. This is just a straight up fucking elevator. That's cool. It turns as well, so we're gonna be exiting like here. This is a pretty long elevator ride. There we go. Furry. Okay, well, here we go. The first Statue of the Seven in Fontaine. And it seems one of the bosses under the ocean. Gorgeous. Did the light just start flooding from the Statue of the Seven just now? It's so weird. Anything like that ever happen?
It's normal for a Statue of the Seven to glow.
Logan, you didn't feel uncomfortable at all.
Huh?
Water. Water speaking to me.
Wow, I feel like I'm using gills to breathe. Good for you. First guy who prepared gills and just buy one.
Try doing something for once, Paimon.
Being in water is scary, pussy.
I'll fish you out again. Fontaine's blessing. Your mysterious power that flows out from a statue to imbue you with the blessing of the transoceanic source water. Your progress will remain unhindered as long as you are moving through the lakes of Fontaine. Under the protection of the transoceanic source water, when you expend while moving on the water, it's not stamina, but aquatic stamina. As such, when your aquatic stamina is expended, you will not drown. So you can't drown! Oh, that's awesome! I'll kill I here. That's another easy one. Oh. Wait. Talking? When does the Aquabus head out? What are those? Those are new. Those look like crabs. Those are not crabs. What are you guys? Oh no, you are crabs. What the hell is that? That's an enemy. Anyway. Oh, this thing's tanky. Too hot to handle. What the f- Flower. Water? You do. Remaining. One more time. We got our first ever Hydro Sigil, too. Oh, dude, I can't really tell if Fontaine is going to be good. It's going to be a good update. Firstly, though, let's have a look at our archive. Let's have a look at how many new enemies there are. Because you all know there's going to be a lot of new enemies. Okay, there's a load of new birds now. Jesus. Loads of new fish, too. And, of course, our Hydro Crystal Fly. So it seems there's another one of these in a different elements. This is a water-spouting phantasm. I don't hear the churls. Whoa, wait. Okay, I think I remember this was supposed to be the Geonite. What are these? What about automatons? I mean, I already saw this thing's filled with automatons, so... Human factions, mystical beasts... It seems I'm still missing a consecrated beast. Wait, am I missing two? Dude, we got a lot of mystical beasts to find. Goodness. I need a lot of exploring. Wait. You can change characters on the water too! Oh dude, that's so cool. That is so cool. That is awesome. Dude, I love this. I love it. Dude, all that hype. All that fucking hype. So fucking worth it. Holy shit. Dude, what's this? I'll have to come back to that later. Oh, dude, this is cool. This is cool. Literally just swimming underwater. What was that? Abilities of the Transoceanic source water and xenochromatic creatures. Sometimes these strange clusters of transoceanic source water will appear beside you, allowing you to unleash power using your will and deliver attacks. When attacking special xenochromatic fontamers aberrants, their power can be absorbed for a certain period. And we got some Sumeru stuff that I never went through. What's up, the Fontaine Blessing? Pneumosia Storage Box. A super safe storage box that absolutely cannot be opened in any way. That is, unless someone manages to figure out if the energy is emitting Osua or Pneuma and uses an attack charge with the opposite alignment to strike overload and unlock it. I mean, Kokomi's not actually a fish. swim like an actual fish. So you cannot drown when you're swimming in Fontaine waters. Bro, you could just water explore as much as you want. I can just go in water and not worry about drowning. This is something the Tower of Fantasy would need too. Just a way where we cannot drown. You know? I do remember we also have ourselves new domains, new artifacts and that stuff. Cool. There is a domain. A Denement of Sin. I don't know which one is what, because I didn't look at the domains yet. Oh, pfft. Well, found an artifact domain. Let's have a look at these new artifacts. Marichaussee Hunter. I think that's how I say it. Normal attack damage plus 15%, 2-piece and 4-piece. When current HP increases or decreases, crit rate will be increased by 12% for 5 seconds. And then the other one. Golden Trout. Increases elemental skill damage by 20% for 2-piece and 4-piece. Increases elemental skill damage by 25%, and additionally, when not on the field, elemental skill damage will be further increased by 25%. This effect will be clear 2 seconds after taking the field. Alright! So for that domain, I need Hydro, Cryo, Pyro, and Animo. Oh, what's on here? There's something on this boat. Let me try. Get on there. What does this do? Oh!
Isoganaito.
Oh, that is cool. Pneuma. Oisea, Ender, Mutual Annihilation. Alright. There are the properties found in the life forms, earth, air, and watery veins of Fontaine. The collision between energies of different properties causes annihilation and the production of greater energies. In this, it is this principle that powers many clockwork mecha. Of course, the power supply of these mecha is unstable, resulting in Pneuma or Oisea aligned energy states. Attacks with the opposite alignment can be used to overload and disable their power supply. You seem a little different. Oh. I don't know what this is gonna do. It's like a Ching trying to pull out a lightning stiletto. Exploring on the water. Let's see, do I drown? I don't! Yo! You actually can't drown!
Wait. What the hell?
Fucking manta rays attacking me. And then I gotta resurface. Oh, it's not cool. There are also creatures in the water that can attack us. How do we kill them? Damage to Fontaine's capital then. So, ice bridging and with low and stamina falling into water doesn't matter anymore. Okay, that's a big one.
ご安心を。やっ。せい。逃がさない。行け。え。か。おだま。は。は。は。え。雪よ。ひ。神里流。止め。またたく間に。行こうよ。
Oh wait, we're closing in on one of the bosses. Marka and Rainbow Dreams.
Yeah!
Yeah. I'm not gonna get any teleport waypoints yet. All I'm gonna do is get chests first, get all the oculi I can, etc. Hydro oculi do really look beautiful. Metal clanking when you're walking.
So cool.
How did I feel my fingerprint? Sad no one's doing the stream. I have to check in with the funny goat. How are we gonna fight on the water is the question. Oh wait, I can do damage with this thing. this is a defense mechanism. That is awesome. Recovery orb. Strength shield crabs. The fuck? Where the hell am I? Oh! Oh, new boss! Let's fight! I love the lava aesthetics down here. Wow, it's like actual boiler. Oh, wait! Okay. You take damage in the boiling water. Noted. I'm excited to fight this thing, though. The fire crab. Come at me, pal. He's got a fire shield, too. I don't have enough work. Oh, look at how small it is. That was a cool boss. I like that. Sure. Let's get this material. See what it has. Emperor's Resolution. The Warhammer of the Emperor of Fire and Iron. Oh, so that's the name of the crab. Cool. I guess. What happens if I try to ice freeze on this water? You can't! That is interesting. I like that. I'll just transport. And by that, I mean drop on boiling water.
Let's go!
cool though. Any enemies I've encountered is like that water thing and crabs. One day I'll be able to run with so many fucking crabs. Ooh! Wait, hang on. Oh, wait! New automatons! Unreal. And this is only one part of Fontaine. Like, we still got possibly a lot more that's gonna come in the future. But if this is literally gonna be all for Fontaine, for like the entirety of the game, then I'm gonna be upset. But I know there's gonna be more. I don't think it will put me in some random quest dialogue. Oh, that wasn't expected. Oh, it's actually rearranged. Well, first, before I do anything, I do want to level up Lynette. She's a sword user, which is nice. What's gonna work well with Lynette? I'm gonna equip the flute on Lynette for now. Artifacts for these animal stuff. February 2nd is her birthday. Tea time. Let's ascend. Okay, so animo damage is what she focuses on. I love her idle animations. Her idle animations are really nice. They're cute. Spare clockwork component, Coppelia. Luminance bells. This is found in the north of the court of Fontaine. It needs gears, so dropped by clockwork mecha. Love those Fontaine wings. Those look beautiful. Different colors? No, that's the most unique one. I think this one would really fit Fontaine as well, though. Okay. There we go. I should level up Kave as well. Like being leveled up. He's like, just let me stay at level 1. Shush, Kachin. Just shush. Not a good blue. A smash after blue. But not today. First off, kill that bird. We have been spotted by some enemies. The clockwork mecha. These things look really cool. Whoa.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Oh, dude, their attack patterns is cool. I love that. I think these things may be my new favorite, even more than the rune guards. That's some elegant attacking! That was some elegant moves! Wow! But my English. But those moves were just... wow! That Hydro one's got skill! Not only skill, she's got style! I really hope to God there's no tree here. What is this? More enemies? Okay, these things seem more like creatures. Those other things seem more like actual robots. These seem more like creatures.
Hello.
Hello there. That's a marker. Let me check my stream chat. Who is it? If my stream chat wants to work, go my phone. Where in my life did I move to? Yo, White Kid 3, hello, welcome to the stream. I'm gonna tell my friends I'm streaming at the moment. It's on my PlayStation, so. How's your day? Hope you have a great day. Hope you're doing good. Check up here. This will be the first teleport waypoint that I would get in Fontaine. Those birds made some rather interesting sounds. I'm not gonna equip. What are you looking at?
Look at that thing. What are you looking at?
Whoa! Wait, oh, that's a fire one. Wait, I don't know Oh, this thing's got a Gatling gun. This thing's got a damn Gatling gun. Good God. That is a Gatling gun. Ow. It said I can alter... or somewhat disable these things. The alternate current effect. There's like a can at the moment. Hack and slash. I think I have a Gatling gun that can also be used like a rocket launcher. That is really unique. Good job again on the design for so many enemies in Mario. Alright, apparently that's what's called Mario. I'm still calling them Mario. I'm still calling them Mario to this day. Man, I am enjoying these enemies. Like, wow. What is this? I gotta break that. I need to find a way to hit this with something. What is that? That's new. I'm seeing more people joining the stream. Hello, everybody. Hello, hello. Hope you're all having an amazing day. Let's see here. Enhanced Pneumosia amplifier. Mysterious clockwork mecha device created by the special energy system produced by Fontaine. This device will grant powerful buffs to the troublesome opponents faced by adventurers or bandits. Of course, as this is a clockwork mecha, you can use the Pneuma Osea Annihilation reaction to overload its system and shut it down. Recon Log Mech. Assault Special Mech. So, it seems the Assault Special Mech come in either Electro or Pyro. Suppression seems to come in Pyro and Dendro. Annihilation, that one seems to come in Hydro and Electro. The Emperor of Fire and Iron. And then these things. The relays. I'm just going around seeing what I can find, see what there could be of interest. There's a chest over here. I love the music. Music's funny. You would never hear me say that the game has funny music, but as of the current moment, the music I'm hearing right now, it's also kind of funny. The crabs. Hello, crabs. I'm going to freeze you. And goodbye. I'm surprised these things never went away. Wait, these are new enemies. Aren't they? That's what I wanted. Oh, I know. There's a casual treasure hoarder. My bad. That music is really good. That music is doing like a pirate vibe. Like a piratey vibe. I don't know why. It just does. But I'm not gonna complain about it. A carrot and whatever that the radish. Radishes aren't that big though. But it's Genshin we're talking about. Wait, that's a J. Wait, hang on. That's a J chamber! Oh wait, hang on. That's the J. That looks like the J chamber. That's cool. Now where's Celestia? That's the sun. That's Ka-ching. I don't see Celestia anywhere. Oh, my TV screen's just kind of dirty. Clean it. No, I should have kind of stayed on here. Goose! We got Goose! More kinds of birds to shoot up and turn into chicken. Or fried meat to be exact. Goose isn't technically chicken. Fluchio was getting chased by a crab. Yes. Ooh. Oh. Thought you were Precious Chest. Well, let's do a Fontaine first. We can get out of this. Yuki omae. Oh, more automatons. Fighter of some sort. Oh, these things have a crystal in them. So this is Pyro. I was expecting to encounter a lot of, you know, new Hydro enemies. Just not at the current moments. That's more of a casual four spots and stuff. It's a lonely meta, Charles. Ah, finally, our first Sealy. Our first two Sealy. Those are some new. Ooh! There's two near me. Sweet. Where's the other one? Now, how am I gonna get you? Oh, wait. Ooh. Ooh, wait, hang on. What are those? Now, I'll look at those in a second. See, one thing I do kind of miss whenever I play Tower of Fantasy, like whenever I play Genshin, I miss like something to propel me into the air so I can glide. Like, you know, with Tower of Fantasy, you have to jetpack. But in Genshin, you don't have a jetpack, you have a wind glider. That's unique. Sealy. One Sealy freed. There's two, and there's three. Be free, my Sealy friends. I'm bringing all three of them to the desired spots. Wait. The fourth one here? Okay, another reason. No, wait, I wanna have a look at the achievements real quick before I do anything else. So all the way down here should be, yep, the Fontaine stuff. There's a new Challenger series, which is kind of sad. Ah, but there was a new meeting in Outrealm. End of the Eternal Return, ever so slightly inferior. The greenery out of space. D dance like you want to win. Desert dwellers, rite of passage. Presumption of guilt. Proof of the Reed Sea Conqueror. The power of science is staggering, and a successful hunt. I gotta complete this with Ghost and Fummy later today, guys. Like, this is gonna be fun. But first, let's have a look at the Fontaine achievements. Same as always. Continent Explorer, Land of Harmonious Springs, Font of All Waters, Sanctuary Pilgrim, Land of Harmonious Springs, Like Waters Clear, Dew Song, Tides Will Guide You Home, Wavering Treasure Hunter, Wave Riding Adventure, Anne in the World, Limiter, Dreamer, and Robotic Dog. Tackle, damn. Oh! Oh wow, oh goddamn! Gee, thanks. No idea where I'm going. Ah, over there. Or not. Isoganaito. Huh. Well, see what else we can explore. Obviously, we do have a lot of underwater exploration to do as well, so I feel like I should probably get that ASAP. Isoganaito. Boy fruit.
Yep.
Wait, that's a tangerine. Now, where are you? Wait. No. No. Hydrograna.
Hut, hut, hut.
I don't know what these things do. Wait. So we used a hydro granite to move this. I also love the puzzles on this. They're actually really interesting. They're interesting, yet fun, unique, and a little challenging. It tests my mind.
What is this? A waterway. Hop. It's like a water platform. That's so cool. Now what?
I'm gonna disappear. Or is this just a forever floating platform? Well, have fun floating. That must be the court of Fontaine. I got it last second, holy shit. My shooting game with Genshin's not there. That's right, I'm gonna hear people saying you mean archery. Shooting, archery, whatever. Oh wait, that's a cool spot. That's like a metal ship. This here is filled with people. Let's go in. Dude, the map shifts so often, you get so many different maps. This is so cool. Where Dark Tides Echo. Wow. Look at this. Like maybe some hidden, chests or something, maybe some oculi. I called it. There's an oculi up there. A lot of metal. No enemies around here. Which is good. I don't see no chests. But I am gonna go for them sweet oculi. Okay. Nice place to have food, man. In relic records, creations of the Hydronation. You will need to gather certain types of collectibles recommended collection sites will be marked on your map for certain items. Your mini map will display nearby collectibles when you get close to recommended sites. Before the challenge starts, you will have to choose the challenge content through conversation with Mollardet. Resources granted by Leyland Blossoms after a challenge completion will depend on the content chosen. Enchanted armor. Get rid of that. Okay, so that and this. This. We need to get a lot more of those. Breacher premises? So that's the other thing I need to kill. Earth, fire, and iron. connect. Wait, they made underwater maps now for every area? That's so cool. It shows separate maps now. I love that. That is class. So many primos from that too. Wow. I mean, why not? Guys are blue. I'm gonna get another blue. They can get an entry point. Fake. See, I always call it. I never call it. Whatever. I never call anything anyways. God damn, like that. God damn it. You know, I can accept that. I can accept that. I'll take the Luke. I'll take a Diluc duplicate any day. So now I know my next 5-star is going to be guaranteed. So now I know I can get guaranteed Focalores. Focalores or whatever. It's going to be really nice. So now I can start building Pity again. You probably never see me get happy over character constellation. I'm happy to get a Diluc constellation. Finally, somebody different than Gigi. I still need Kaching constellations, though. Kaching's still C0. The game doesn't want to give me any. I got a fucking new little collie. Oh. She has a... We don't talk about our artifacts. We do not talk about that artifact. I should probably start leveling up Kali's artifacts, to be honest. I do feel like they can be better. But at the current moment, I can't really do much for artifacts, so yeah. Elemental battery got it.
Okay.
No, let me pull up my chat again. Jonathan Tan, welcome to the stream chat. I'll take this for now for Kali. I don't really want to spend too much at the moment because, well, I barely have any artifacts to level up Kali stuff. So she's going to be stuck at, you know, the usual 10k HP. I don't have stamina.
冒険も商売もチャンスは一瞬なの。
Oculi up here first. Oh, wait. Wait, what is that? What is that? What is that creature? That looks so cool. I gotta fight it. I mean, obviously he's guarding a chest. Of course I'm gonna have to fight it. But that thing looks so unique. That is one of those tough ones to get. Can't escape me. That's not over yet, you can't
see it.
Kapow! Let's alert you. Let's see if this will actually work. It does! That is amazing. And there's another one guarding here, too. Let's alert you. Come over here. Boom. That little charge got nothing on me. Okay, so we got one on the right, which we need the purple one for, and one on the purple, which we need the other color for. So first things first, we gotta get this light orb. Find a purple orb, which is right over here. Excuse me. God damn it. Borrow this from you. Oh, god damn. Let me get the light orb again. I need the light orb for all these visionaries. Alright, which one are you first? You. Fuck's sake. Oh, he regained it. Really? Wait. I just realized. The fucking Pneuma and Osea. It's quanta and imagery. Fucking Honkai. Ah. There's Celestia. Going on top of the capital of Fontaine, huh? Expected. Back.
休むことも大事だけど、気を抜きすぎてはダメよ。無駄な時間を過ごしてると仕事が終わらないわよ。冒険も商売もチャンスは一瞬なの。休むことも大事だけど、気を抜きすぎてはダメよ。冒険も商売もチャンスは一瞬なの。休むことも大事だけど、気を抜きすぎてはダメよ。 冒険も商売もチャンスは一瞬なの。無駄な時間を過ごしてると仕事が終わらないわよ。休むことも大事だけど、気を抜きすぎてはダメよ。無駄な時間を過ごしてると仕事が終わらないわよ。冒険も商売もチャンスは一瞬なの。 無駄な時間を過ごしてると仕事が終わらないわよ。休むことも大事だけど、気を抜きすぎてはダメよ。
ふむふむ。
無駄な時間を過ごしてると仕事が終わらないわよ。冒険も商売もチャンスは一瞬なの。無駄な時間を過ごしてると仕事が終わらないわよ。
ふむふむ。
休むことも大事だけど、気を抜きすぎてはダメよ。
ふむふむ。
冒険も商売もチャンスは一瞬なの。
ふむふむ。
住むことも大事だけど、 気を抜きすぎてはダメよ。
I'm back, ladies and gentlemen. And as always, it's back.
Exploring
the wonderful world of Teybot. Teybot, Tibet, whatever. If I can just find three more. I hate boars. Huh? Oh, it's in here, isn't it? Bro, how was I supposed to know this was gonna be in here? I should have went with the door boat. Oh, I guess we're gonna have to run away. Wait, I kind of wonder. Can't we just go back here and see if it's back? The tour boat's not here. Dang it. My way. That's underground. Thank you.
休むことも大事だけど、気を抜きすぎてはダメよ。
Alright, well, we got a long way to go.
無駄な時間を過ごしてると仕事が終わらないわよ。
ふむふむ。
冒険も商売もチャンスは一瞬なの。無駄な時間を過ごしてると仕事が終わらないわよ。
I'm gonna have to go a pretty long way. Also, guys, with Brawlhalla, I do have the goal of trying to reach level 40 Orion, which is gonna happen pretty soon. The week 2 challenges for Brawlhalla are now out too, so I'm gonna have to try and complete those.
冒険も商売もチャンスは一瞬なの。休むことも大事だけど、気を抜きすぎてはダメよ。
I don't much have to walk.
冒険も商売もチャンスは一瞬なの。
Peacocks or something? I don't know, peacock when I'm flying. Well, we made it to the Court of Fontaine, so... What the fuck is this? Oh, wait.
無駄な時間を過ごしてると仕事が終わらないわよ。 冒険も商売もチャンスは一瞬なの。無駄な時間を過ごしてると仕事が終わらないわよ。休むことも大事だけど、気を抜きすぎてはダメよ。
To find these other enemies, but first we gotta get Statue to 7. Else we can't really do much.Wait, whoa! Whoa! Bro, this looks beautiful. Hands down.Sumeru is still the most beautiful area in the play, in the game, but Watatsumi Island, in my opinion, is still the most beautiful. More beautiful than Sumeru. Totally not because I like Kokomi. What's this? Ah. Frimora.Like, I know a lot of my friends are quitting Genshin and playing Tower of Fantasy. But you do understand, Tower of Fantasy in this case is better than Genshin. Though I can't escape from Genshin. Like, I still love playing Genshin every now and then. It's a habit.No, wait, that's my touring boat. Isn't it? Wait, where is my touring boat?
Ikoyo!
There's nothing over that GSOB area. That was fast. Oh, and here's the statue. Ah, there's the boss. So there's one more small area left to be explored, which is over here. Bro, there's even waypoints underwater. What? Final statue here we need to explore too. So I feel like we should probably get that done too before we do anything else. more substantial.
20 oculi. Dang. Right, well, let's resonate with Hydro. I want to see how good the Hydro Traveler is. Hydro, land of fair springs. Oh wait, it takes away your health. So Hydro Traveler has to be specifically built in HP now. Fuck are you? I'm not gonna bother you, fuck you. What's here? Check something real quick. Recent.
Shorty. Lady Farina. We have ourselves some new weapons. Oh, jeez. We got 3 new swords. The hell? Wolf Fang. Finale of the Dean. And Fluve Sender Ferriman. For Claymore, we got 2 new ones. We got 3 new ones. The Makaira Aquamarine. The Talking Stick. And the Tidal Show. What about the Spear? Spear, I got 2 new ones. Ballad of the Fjords and Rightful Reward. This thing here. I never had Sacrificial Fragment? Whatever. For this, this has already been here. So we got Sacrificial Jade and Flowing Purity. And then for bows, we got another line, Scion of the Blazing Sun, Song of Stillness, and I believe for legendary, for 5 stars. For weapons, for swords, we don't have new ones. For claimers, we don't have new ones. Poems, we don't have new. And catalysts, we don't have new. The only thing that's new here is the first great magic bow. And as I asked a fucking glad that I lost my 50-50 to the Luke. So I just build a fucking pity for, Fossilores. Oh, wait, hang on. There's a blacksmith down here. So the Adventurers Guild stuff is like down here in this area. So you even have automatons roaming the city. Wait, huh? Oh! Oh, wait, that makes it so much better. That makes it so much better. This is better. You can buy the forging paragrams. Yes! Finally, Mihoyo did something good for once. Where do I get these? Condensed crystals found in Illinus on the surface. So, Illinus. It's for the bow. I want to get the sword.
Thank you.
収穫ね。悪くないお宝だわ。急がない。瞬く間に。ジア！よっ。
雪を前。
ご助力を。リカ、逃がさない。 Minarai Ranger, Sanjo!
ごとく!
またたく間に。
陣営のごとく!
にならないと。 やっと私の出番? きちんと計画してくださいね。 瞬く間に。
いなきゃダメだね。 気持ちいい。体もほぐれてきた。よいしょ。
Thank you.
I'm not gonna watch too much since my update isn't done yet and I don't want spoilers, but damn you and your internet.
かつて。
MiHoYo finally changed the battle pass, huh? They added more weapons. Oh. So really on these ones, let's look at these new weapon stats real quick. So, Wolf Fang. North Wind Wolf. Damage dealt by elemental skill and elemental burst is increased by 16%. When an elemental skill hits an opponent, its crit rate will be increased by 2%. When an elemental burst hits an opponent, its crit rate will be increased by 2%. Both of these effects last 10 seconds separately and have a 4 mech stacks and can be triggered once every 0.1 seconds. Right. The Talking Stick. Silver Tongue. Attack will be increased by 16% for 15 seconds after being affected by Pyro. This effect can be triggered once every 12 seconds, and all elemental damage bonus will be increased by 12% for 15 seconds after being affected by Hydro, Cryo, Electro, or Dendro. And this effect can be triggered once every 12 seconds as well. Sacrificial Jade. Jade Circulation. When not on the field for more than 5 seconds, max HP will be increased by 32%, and Elemental Mastery will be increased by 40%. These effects will be cancelled after the wielder has been on the field for 10 seconds. Scion of the Blazing Sun, and this is a weapon I've been looking forward to. The Way of Sunfire. After a charged arrow hits an opponent, a Sunfire arrow will descend upon the opponent hit, dealing 60% damage attack as damage, and applying the Heat Seer effect to the opponent damaged by said arrow for 10 seconds. The opponent affected by Heart Seer will also take 28% more charged attack damage from the wielder, and a Sunfire arrow can be triggered once every 10 seconds. And then the final thing, the Ballad of the Fjords. Tales of the Tundra. When there are at least 3 different elemental types in your party, elemental mastery will be increased by 120%. Doesn't sound as good as, you know, this thing. I have to admit, Scorn of the Blazing Sun sounds better than Viridescent Hunt. This sounds more better for, like, a support. For, like, you know, compared to, like, the Solar Pearl. These ones. I'm struggling between these two. So, I don't know if this one will be good for some characters. I feel like I could maybe try this with the Luke. I don't know. This, on the other hand, Wolf Fang. While I do like it, I still prefer the Black Sword. Black Sword will always be better, in my opinion. Alright, time to Crispity again. Stop giving me heart attacks, Hoyoverse. Again? I mean, I'm not complaining. I've heard Sacrificial Fragment's pretty good.
Let's
see here.
無駄な時間を過ごしてると仕事が終わらないわよ。
ふむふむ。
休むことも大事だけど、気を抜きすぎてはダメよ。冒険も商売もチャンスは一瞬なの。
ふむふむ。
ふむふむ。無駄な時間を過ごしてると仕事が終わらないわよ。
ふむふむ。
ふむ。休むことも大事だけど、気を抜きすぎてはダメよ。
ふむふむ。
無駄な時間を過ごしてると仕事が終わらないわよ。休むことも大事だけど、気を抜きすぎてはダメよ。
Damn you and your internet. Usual ghost.